So good morning to all of you. Myself Mahesh Pingle. Today we are going to deliver the derivation on amplitude modulation in time domain. So it is a mathematical representation. Basically, as we all of know that in amplitude modulation the envelope is created. So through this particular lecture we want to derive the time domain representation of amplitude modulated wave. So before going to that particular further discussion, let us have a glance overlook over the amplitude modulation process. So as all of we know that modulator, it is always placed at the transmitter. So for doing a amplitude modulation, the amplitude modulator needs two different signals. First one is the modulating signal, that is also our information signal. We may also call it as a baseband signal. So the information which we want to transmit for a longer distance, that is called as the modulating signal. So modulating signal, it is always a low frequency signal. So only because of its low frequency, it is not possible to send a low frequency signal for a longer distance. So, to send that particular low frequency modulating signal over a longer distance for the several kilometers, we have to superimpose that modulating signal on a high frequency carrier signal. So, second signal which we need, it is called as the carrier signal. So, carrier signal has always the frequency higher than that of your low frequency modulating signal. So modulating signal has always a low frequency and carrier frequency is always higher than that of your modulating signal. So one of the input for the AM modulator is the modulating signal. Second input, it is the carrier signal, and the output of AM modulator block, it is amplitude modulated wave. So what here we are observing, suppose this is a low frequency modulating signal or the information signal which we want to transmit. So on x axis it represents time, on y axis it is the amplitude or the voltage level of that particular low frequency modulating signal. Similarly, if we draw a waveform for the carrier signal, so on x axis it is a time, on y axis it is amplitude, and a high frequency signal, it is plotted here with respect to time versus amplitude. Now, what our definition of amplitude modulator says, that in amplitude modulation, the amplitude of the carrier gets varied with respect to instantaneous change in amplitude of the modulating signal by keeping the phase frequency of the carrier constant, is called as the amplitude modulation. So in amplitude modulation, we are changing the amplitude of the carrier and keeping frequency and phase constant. So whatever the envelope or the output waveform generated of amplitude modulated wave, it is look like this one. Now our basic motive is to make a mathematical representation of this particular AM time domain wave. So let us have a look on the nature of the modulating signal. Suppose, first of all, a modulating signal. So as we previously said that the modulating signal is a low frequency signal. So if I represent this modulating signal like this one, so on x-axis it is time. On y axis is amplitude. So for meanwhile, I will demonstrate the peak amplitude of the modulating signal by EM. Now the equation for the modulating signal with sinusoidal nature is like, so it is a baseband signal, it is also called as information signal, it is also called as a modulating signal. Signal. So mathematical representation of modulating signal is modulating signal is EM is equal to capital EM cos omega MT. Here cos represent the sinusoidal nature of the modulating signal, while omega M is nothing but 2 pi FM is angular frequency of modulating signal, while FM linear frequency of modulating signal. Okay, so we represented modulating signal. We have noted down the equation for the mathematical representation of modulating signal. So EM is equal to capital EM cos omega MT, where omega M is 2 pi FM, angular frequency of the modulating signal. FM is linear frequency of the modulating signal. Now, let us represent carrier signal. So carrier signal mathematical representation. So first of all, we'll draw the waveform of carrier signal. So as we obviously know that carrier is a high frequency signal, total number of cycles within 1 second, it also gets increased. So suppose this is a high frequency carrier signal, so we label it as a carrier signal. On x-axis it is a time, on y-axis it is amplitude. Meanwhile, I am labeling a peak amplitude as EC. So instantaneous value of carrier signal is represented by EC. So EC is equal to EC cos omega CT. So small EC represent instantaneous carrier signal value, capital EC represent peak amplitude of the carrier signal. Similarly, omega C is equal to 2 pi fc t is angular velocity of carrier signal. Similarly, fc is angular frequency of the carrier signal. Similarly, fc is the linear frequency of carrier signal. Now, if these two signals, carrier signal and the modulating signal, it is given to the modulator. So suppose EM is fed here and EC is fed here. So whatever the output, it is nothing but the AM wave. So we are giving it to the AM modulator. So the output is represented like this one. So it is nothing but an envelope. So it just look like this one. So we'll draw the envelope of amplitude modulated wave. So when there is no any kind of information available in baseband signal, at that time there is no any change in the carrier. But as soon as the modulating signal gets changed with respect to its instantaneous value, the carrier also changes its amplitude. So amplitude of the carrier gets varied with respect to instantaneous change in amplitude of the modulating signal by keeping phase and frequency constant. So it is a time. Now suppose this particular voltage level, it is called as EC, and the modulating signal voltage is EM. So this one is EM. So the peak amplitude of amplitude modulated wave, it is EC plus EM. So this particular waveform represents AM waveform in time domain. So when there is no any change in carrier, it is called as unmodulated carrier. So at this particular point, it is, suppose if we label this voltage level, so it is EC minus EM, and whatever the peak level, it is EC plus EM, and whatever the waveform we drawn here, it is called as envelope. Right. So now if we represent the AM waveform, so mathematical representation of AM is equal to EAM. So EAM is the instantaneous value of amplitude modulated waveform, is equal to A cos 2 pi fc t, where A is the envelope of AM wave. Now if we draw the value of AM wave or A envelope, so but A is nothing but EC plus small EM, which is equal to EC plus, now we know the value of EM, it is capital EM cos 2 pi FMT. Therefore AM equation becomes EAM is equal to, now we substitute the value of A in this particular equation. So EAM is equal to EC plus EM cos 2 pi FMT into cos 2 pi FCT. So it is like this one. Now for simplicity, I may write EC plus EM cos of omega MT cos of omega CT. Okay. Now we'll take EC as a common factor. Therefore, if we take EC as a common factor, then equation becomes EAM is equal to, if we take EC common, it becomes 1 plus EM by EC cos of omega MT bracket complete cos of omega CT. Now this EM by EC, it is always represented by M, which is called as modulation index. This modulation index has a vital role in amplitude modulation. So M is equal to modulation index is equal to EM by EC. So the equation becomes EAM is equal to EC into bracket 1 plus M cos of omega MT into cos of omega CT. Okay. Now, if we multiply further, what we get? Suppose if we multiply EC and cos omega CT into the bracket terms, so what we'll get? EC cos of omega CT plus M EC cos omega MT cos omega CT. Now, as all of we know, 2 cos A cos B is equal to cos of A plus B plus cos of A minus B. We may also write as cos A cos B is equal to 1 by 2 cos of A plus B plus 1 by 2 cos of A minus B. Now, similarly, here we are having a term cos of omega MT into cos of omega CT. So, as per this particular cos A cos B, the above equation becomes EAM is equal to EC cos of omega CT plus, for simplicity, I'll write here plus M EC by 2 cos of omega CT plus omega MT plus M EC by 2 cos of omega CT minus omega MT. If we take a common factor of T, what we will get? So EAM is equal to EC cos of omega CT plus MEC by 2 cos of omega C plus omega M of T plus MEC by 2 cos of omega C minus omega M of T. So, these are the three distinct parts of amplitude modulated wave. The first section EC cos omega CT represents carrier signal. The second part, which is called as the plus sign, having a plus sign, it represents upper sideband. And the second or third section, it will represent lower side band. So this is all about the mathematical equation. We will just take a review of that. So this is a modulating signal. So in modulating signal, peak amplitude is EM, capital EM. So instantaneous value of the modulating signal is represented by EM is equal to EM cos omega MT, where omega M is equal to 2 pi FM, which is called as angular frequency, and FM is called as the linear frequency of the modulating signal. Then we represented similarly the carrier. So carrier instantaneous value is represented by EC is equal to capital EC cos of omega CT, where EC is the instantaneous carrier signal value, capital EC is the peak amplitude of the carrier signal, omega C is equal to 2 pi FC is the angular frequency of the carrier signal, and fc is the linear frequency of the carrier signal. These both em and ec, it is given to the amplitude modulator at transmitter side. So there is a generation of amplitude modulated wave which looks like this one. So we call it as an envelope. So whenever there is no any kind of modulating signal, carrier does not change its amplitude. So this particular section, it is called as unmodulated carrier. And where the instantaneous change in modulating signal amplitude we observe, the carrier also changes its amplitude. So whatever the change in amplitude, it is EC plus EM and EC minus EM. So mathematically we represented it as a EAM is equal to A cos of 2 pi FCT. But A is nothing but EC plus EM. So small EM is instantaneous modulating signal plus carrier. So carrier peak amplitude plus EM cos 2 pi FMT is the next step. Then after we substitute the value of A in this particular equation, what we will get? EAM is equal to EC plus EM cos 2 pi FMT into cos 2 pi FCT. We do some mathematical manipulation and we take EC as a common factor. So 1 plus EM by EC. Now this EM by EC, it is called as the modulation index, and it plays a very important role in amplitude modulation process. Then we multiplied EC and cos omega CT within the bracket. We use a trigonometric formula, cos A cos B, 1 by is equal to 1 by 2 cos of A plus B, 1 by 2 cos of A minus B. And as per this particular trigonometric formula, we substitute the values of cos omega MT and cos omega CT. Finally, what we get? EAM is equal to cos omega CT. It is nothing but the carrier signal. MEC by 2, it is cos omega CT plus omega MT plus MEC by 2 cos of omega CT minus omega MT. Now we take a T as a common factor, and these three sections we observed for the amplitude wave. So this is all about the mathematical representation of AM wave in time domain. So for this particular time, thank you very much for your kind patience and listening. Thank you.